Hi, I'm John from OWC. Today we're going to talk about the difference between Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4. The announcement of the new M1 Pro and M1 Max computers have raised some confusion around the already slightly confusing difference between Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4. So we thought it would be a good idea to clear up some of that confusion and address two of the main issues that have been showing up. First, why weren't the M1 Max designated as Thunderbolt 4 compatible? And second, it's been a year. Why aren't we seeing more Thunderbolt 4 peripherals besides docks and hubs? I think to answer that first question, we need to understand a common misconception. The misconception is that Thunderbolt 4 is the successor to Thunderbolt 3. Typically, when you go from version 3 to version 4, there are going to be some notable increases in whatever measurement you're using. Now, while this is technically true in terms of Thunderbolt, Thunderbolt 4's advancements mainly refer to standards enforcements, rather than an increase in data transfer speeds or functionality. Both Thunderbolt 3 and 4 have data streams of up to 40 gigabits per second, but Thunderbolt 4 requires cables and connections to hit that speed, whereas some Thunderbolt 3 Windows PC machines can get by only hitting as low as 20 gigs a second, along with some other limitations. Thunderbolt 3 can go as fast and already does if you're on a Mac, you just need to make sure you know what you're getting. The same rings true for 4K monitor connections and PCIe lanes. Thunderbolt 4 will enforce the highest standards for each, while Thunderbolt 3 can pass by with a lower standard, or hit the highest standard, depending on the host, cable, device, etc. Now, it's worth noting that Thunderbolt 3 performance hasn't been an issue since Apple launched the 2016 Intel Mac machines. Since then, every Mac has met all the enforcement criteria that Thunderbolt 4 requires today. In fact, with Mac machines, you wouldn't notice any difference between Thunderbolt 3 or 4. To summarize, if you see something supports Thunderbolt 3 and it's a Windows PC, keep reading the specs to make sure you know what you're getting. Now, if it's an Apple machine or if it's marked Thunderbolt 4, you know you'll be getting the highest performance possible. Ultimately, it comes down to the host machine. Devices like docks and external drives that support these hosts are agnostic in almost every single case. Okay, so going back to why the M1 Max weren't able to technically use Thunderbolt 4 in their marketing language. Simply put, their new Apple silicon architecture wasn't ready to support dual 4K monitor displays via Thunderbolt. The Intel Max all did, and this has now been updated with the new M1 Pro and M1 Max products. So yes, the only missing piece with the M1 was the ability to run the dual displays over Thunderbolt. And it's why the newly released M1 Pro and M1 Max Apple models do call out Thunderbolt 4, considering this capability is now included. Now onto the question of why you're not seeing more Thunderbolt 4 peripherals. While Thunderbolt 4 enforces requirement standards for the host or computer offering these ports, it's still technically the same 40 gigabits per second Thunderbolt 3 USB-C capability we're all familiar with. What it comes down to is the fact that existing Thunderbolt 3 chipsets are not replaced with Thunderbolt 4, and they are simply the best solutions for our storage products, like Thunderblade, Envoy Pro SX, Envoy Pro FX, and Thunderbase, etc. In fact, solutions like that cannot be built with so-named Thunderbolt 4 today, as that's not what those chipsets are designed to be used for. The only thing a Thunderbolt 4 peripheral can do that wasn't on prior Thunderbolt 3 chipsets is add more Thunderbolt 3 or 4 Type-C ports. This really isn't a Thunderbolt 4 thing, it's really that they simply named these new chipsets with the ability to support more Thunderbolt connections, Thunderbolt 4. By the way, any Mac with Thunderbolt 3 that's running OS 11 or later can use these new Thunderbolt 4 peripherals too. It all makes sense until you try to explain it with words. Whether you have a Thunderbolt 3 or 4 system, Thunderbolt 3 is the best for most other peripherals, especially high-performance ones like Thunderbase. Making these with Thunderbolt 4, which is designed for hubs and docks, could actually make these types of solutions slower. Thunderbolt 4 peripheral chipsets just give OWC more options for the different solutions you need, and we build everything with the Thunderbolt chipsets best suited for those solutions. Apple really did things right. It's because of the full Thunderbolt 3 standards implementation that we get to use the best of all Thunderbolt peripherals today. Windows PCs with less complete Thunderbolt implementations aren't so lucky. Thunderbolt 4, more than anything, is a standards implementation, and it's because Apple was already meeting these standards that Thunderbolt 3 Max were already there with Thunderbolt 4. One final note regarding cables. Your cables are interchangeable between Thunderbolt 3 and 4. However, a Thunderbolt 4 cable is recommended to ensure that you always have the maximum of up to 40 gigabits per second of data transfer possible and certified power delivery up to 100 watts. Thunderbolt 4 cables will also support 40 gigabits per second throughput at up to 2 meters in length, up from the 0.7 meter maximum of a passive Thunderbolt 3 cable. Plus, Thunderbolt 4 cables make sure they are backwards compatible with any USB-C type connection. In the past, Thunderbolt 3 cables met specific Thunderbolt needs, but with different USB support. Similar to the host standards of Thunderbolt 4, Thunderbolt 4 cables now require fully universal support for all things Type-C, including all modes of power delivery and USB speeds from USB 2 to USB 4, and everything in between up to 40 gigabits per second. It doesn't matter what you use a Thunderbolt 4 cable to connect. Type-C to Type-C port, a Thunderbolt 4 cable will always provide maximum possible power and/or data supported by the devices connected. Thunderbolt 4 is the one cable that works for everything today and yesterday, period. So if you're looking to buy a new cable, you might as well go with this option since it's totally universal. So is Thunderbolt 4 better than Thunderbolt 3? Functionally, no, but for knowing what you're getting, sure. In reality, Thunderbolt 4 could just be looked at as more of a marketing position, one that guarantees new Windows PC machines have all the capabilities that Macs have provided since the beginning of Thunderbolt 3. I think a more appropriate naming convention might have been Thunderbolt 3A, but at least now the 4 aligns with 40 gigabits per second. So Thunderbolt 4 is important for PCs, as it means you're fully compatible and fully capable for all the great Thunderbolt devices available. This is something that was already the case with all Thunderbolt Type-C Macs since the first so equipped ones in 2016. If you need more Thunderbolt ports, that's made possible at long last with the latest Thunderbolt 4 peripheral chipsets. For everything else, existing Thunderbolt 3 chipsets are equally, if not more, capable, where the design specialty is all about peripheral performance and capability. To sum it up, in this case, an upgrade in number doesn't necessarily equate to an upgrade in performance. It's simply a guarantee or enforcement of previous performance benchmarks. I hope this was helpful in clearing up any confusion. If you have any other questions you think we can help with, as always, go ahead and put them in the comments, and we'll do our best to answer them. From everyone here at OWC, thank you, and we'll see you next time.